I am so lucky. This is one of my favorite actors, one of my all-time favorite movies. Chazz Palminteri joins the show. Chazz, how are you?
I'm good, Steve. How are you?
I'm good. So you're going to be taking the role of Sonny a couple of days a week over in the role on the Bronx Tale on Broadway. What made you do it?
Well, Nick Cordero, who plays Sonny on Broadway, he's doing a film. So they were going to cast, they were going to look to cast another Sonny. And, you know, they asked me, you know, Tommy Mottola and De Niro said, gee, you want to go in and play Sonny? And I asked for a while, and I said, yeah, sure, why not? So I just thought it was a good time for me, and I'm going to go in and play it. It's actually the first time in history that a writer has played, that an actor has done the play on Broadway, and then the feature film, and then the musical on Broadway. So it's kind of it's kind of a first.
Did they make you audition?
No.
Knowing what you know now, what advice would you give C? What advice would you give young you right now?
Well, I mean, it's basically, my son is, 22 years old, and I same advice I give to him, you know. I said, if you want to be very successful, be really good at what you do and be well-liked. If you do those two things, you'll make it. You know? I still tell people today, even though the door locks are different, I always say, look, the girl's got to at least make an attempt to let you in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even if the door is open, she has to try to click it or something, but she just can't leave you out there by yourself, you know. So, the door test works, man. It worked back then, and it still works, I think. You know, a lot of times when I get on an airplane, as soon as the stewardess shuts the door, I hear the pilot going, "Now you can't leave."
He knows you're there.
He knows I'm there, you know. I hear that a lot. I hear the throw in the bathroom. I hear it's better to be loved or feared.
Mm-hmm.
I hear one of the great ones, is your wife one of the great ones? Did she pass the test? But you know what? That's just a compliment, and I take that.
It's your legacy.
That's my legacy, and I'm fine with that.
Of all the movies you were in, what was your favorite movie?
Well, of course, Bronx Tale, Usual Suspects, Bullets Over Broadway. I mean, that one I got nominated for Academy Award, so that's a special movie. And I love the movie. I thought it was one of Woody Allen's best movies. And a movie called Guide to Recognizing Your Saints is one of my favorite movies that I did with Robert Downey Jr. and Tatum, Channing Tatum. I've been very fortunate. I've been in almost 60 movies.
You know? Yeah.
So, over a long career, and I've been, you know, one actors, they just want to be in one classic. I've been in a handful, so I'm really I'm very blessed and very fortunate to be in a lot of these movies.
What's it like acting with De Niro? You know, how do you two play along?
Oh, it was great. I mean, you know, it's like playing basketball with Michael Jordan. You know?
It is.
It's, you know, you're playing tennis, you know, with, you know, some of the great players. It's just great. I mean, you're excited by it, and you never know what to expect, and you want to match up and be equal to him, and that's it. Just makes you better, I think. That's what it does.
What's the best thing he ever said to you when you were working together, especially when you're starting out?
I think he said, don't read reviews. He said, never read reviews. He said, because they'll hurt you, and the good ones will hurt you worse than the bad ones, he said. He said, because if you're going to believe the good ones, you'll believe the bad ones. So it's better not to read anything. And I never forgot that. And you know what? I never did. After that, after Bronx Tale, I never read another review about myself.